Beach Village District Monthly Meeting. It's Wednesday, May 11th, 2016. Can we please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
My breath out.
Before we start the meeting, I'd like to take a moment of silence. A longtime beach resident, beach property owner, beach business person, and also the mother and mother-in-law of John and Ann Kane, Kathleen Badcock, passed away. So I'd like to take a moment of silence. All right. So... this is one of the shortest meetings I think we're going to have because we don't have a list of people. John was going to speak tonight and Glenn French was going to speak tonight and Glenn had a foot issue or something, I believe. A leg issue, so it's going to be pretty quick.
No, he can't. He's having trouble walking.
He's having trouble, yeah.
And I'm going to tell him you said that was fresh.
I sign it.
I know.
Could have carried him up the stairs, huh?
Yeah.
There is an elevator, yeah. All right, we're going to start right off with old business. So is there anybody, you have any old business, Bob?
I wrote an email to the town planner, and he said if the town were to put up some evacuation signage, they could get some credits under the community rating system for that activity. So hopefully that's something that will be considered by the town.
Maureen, do you have any old business?
Yes, I do.
I just wanted to make sure that people remember that the prom is coming on the 21st, on the Saturday. Oh, was that? Stealing your thunder?
No, go ahead.
Yes, and on the 29th from 1 to 4 p.m., we're going to have a pre-audition for the Idol. Something we're going to try. We have a DJ coming, and we're going to have our auditions on the stage from 1 to 4. So all you singers out there, come on along.
All right.
And that is all I have.
So the 21st is the Grand March, is what you're talking about.
21st is the Grand March, about
5:30. Yeah. Well, entertainment starts at 5.
Yes.
So the Continental is going to be there this year.
Yes, they are.
Someone different. We haven't had them very much there. So. And then the march will start at 5:30, and my son Anthony will be in the march. So it'll be interesting to see.
So if everybody wants to have the picture taken with Anthony.
So I'm sure at some stage his father will embarrass him. So
You probably already did.
Yeah.
Too late.
Yeah, exactly. All right, how about new business?
We're continuing to work on this event for July 6th. It's still in the planning stage, but it's pretty far advanced, and we should have some public information out in the ether within a week or two concerning it. We've signed a bunch of people. Maureen, I'm sure, can go into more detail.
No, I was just going to say that we've had tremendous cooperation with...
What is it?
It's fun. It's
all
you need to know, Barbara.
It's
right up your alley.
So
what tends to happen?
We're going to have the sandcastles will remain up, and we're going to have as a backdrop, we're going to have some events like that trampoline thing on the beach, just something to kind of call the people forth.
And hopefully
volleyball as well.
What tends to happen is we have a big climb and busy and everything's great, and then all of a sudden we get a drop right after the 4th. And it seems to be a little vacuum area that we could maybe come up with some promotion to get some things happening and bring some people down and maybe bring some... And we're working with the town...
Rec
department, sorry. Diane is working with us on that. We're going to have a lot of local kids as well as kids that are from... that are here on
and
vacation.
And with the cooperation of Brian Wilson as well.
Exactly. And so this will give a little bit of activity on the beach when we're not as busy, but also an age group that gets lost seems to be... There's always stuff for little kids, there's always stuff for the older kids, but that tween age, we're gearing a lot of this to. Am I right with that?
Yeah. The target group would be like 8 to 14.
There will also be entertainment on the stage that day. It's going to be kind of, you walk up to it and there's things happening all around. There's going to be a DJ on the stage playing music. We have a dance company coming
in to give a dance lesson.
Kids coming in who are going to perform on the stage. Just all around.
And if we're lucky, Maureen might sing for us.
Maybe a I was approached by someone in the Shop and Save who took umbrage with your constant reminder about my singing and my cello playing in the seventh grade. So some people are paying attention to you people.
That's
I don't know great. Why.
Well, there's a lot of talk. We want to see some action.
Yeah.
Times, like when does it all start?
10 to 2, 10 to 3, somewhere in there.
Yeah, we're going to start at 10, and I think the other things are done at 2, right? But you said that we might keep the DJ on
the
stage at 3 or something like
longer.
That. You know.
One of the more fascinating things is we got a guy coming who's got a bunch of very large plastic balls that the kids literally go into and play soccer, bubble ball.
Adults as well, by the way. Not just kids.
Adults under 14 are more than welcome in the ball.
No, adults.
Yeah.
Well, they call them bubble balls. There's more names for these foolish things, but they're very fun, and it'll be fun to look at, I think, you know.
We're looking for people to go down by the water's edge and make sure the balls stay on the scene.
Some of it's going to be fenced in, correct? Am I right? I think I can't
answer
the fencing.
Has a hill form. You know, 495, you'll see them on the left. They have a special place where you can roll down the hill.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but I think they fill it up with water, don't they?
Nope, it's just air. Well, some may have water.
Yeah. No kidding.
Yeah. But you can roll down the hill.
All right, you give a demonstration on it.
Yes,
I've already done it. You can tell.
And also, Greg Grady will give a demonstration on how to make sandcastles.
Yes, he's going to demonstrate.
On the same
sand sculptures.
Sculptures.
It might not be a castle. It might be a sculpture.
Well, you better have a sculpture.
We're going to start him off on castles.
Okay.
That's right.
All right, excellent. All right, so some of the new business for me. Do you have anything else before I start?
No, okay. I think so.
Coming up in a couple weeks at the Board of Selectmen's meeting, there's going to be discussions about Ocean Boulevard, and the state, the DOT, wants to come in and basically rip up Ocean Boulevard and regrade it. Right now we're at 8 or 9 layers. I'm not quite sure how many layers. And if anybody that has businesses on the front, they know how much water, when there's a big storm or anything, floods their properties. The sidewalks are falling apart, and water is coming off the boulevard, and it's definitely affecting a lot of businesses, a lot of probably homes that are on the boulevard. And this isn't just the main part of, you know, from N Street to A Street. This is Ocean Boulevard all the way down. And hopefully we can get as much of Ocean Boulevard redone as possible. Down by Boar's Head, if you look at where Rick Griffin's place is and Little Jack's, you see the flooding that goes on there. So what the state has come up with is the state owns from the sidewalk, so they own the sidewalk to the ocean. But the state of New Hampshire does not maintain sidewalks. Never have. They say they never will. So what the state has offered is to do all this work, rebuild the sidewalks, have raised sidewalks, do all this work on the beach, and pay for it, but they want the town to maintain the sidewalks. So maintain the sidewalks could mean a lot of things. We haven't got full definitions of maintaining the sidewalks. I asked someone, well, what is the lifespan of a sidewalk? 15 to 20 years of if it's made well. Well, the state doesn't do it halfway. They do it right. So if there's a hole in the sidewalk, does that mean filling in the hole in the sidewalk? Maintaining the sidewalk also means keeping the sidewalk clear. So they want the town to do that. I think the investment that the town has spent on the new infrastructure with the $12.5 million sewer infrastructure that's been put in, and then you have the state spending $14.5 million on the other side of the road, now we're seeing a lot of properties, not just new condos, but a lot of homes and a lot of people redoing the front of their properties, cleaning up their properties, and what you're seeing is a huge investment on the west side. So this is beneficial to the town, it's beneficial to the beach, it's beneficial to the state. I have figures that I have to go over at some point showing increases because of all this work. Well, right now, the main part of Hampton Beach is coming down that boulevard. And if that boulevard isn't replaced, and this is nothing that's going to get done next year. This is put into a 10-year plan. If we miss this 10-year plan, are we talking 20 years before we get that boulevard replaced? It needs to be done. They can't put another layer on. If they put another layer on, everybody is going to be flooded. So I think we need to work with the town, work with the state. I think everybody seems to work well together. We just need to make sure everybody figures out what they're doing. The Village District is there to help the state, the town. We get along great with DRED, DOT. We have great people from DOT that have helped us. So I want to make a motion, and I hope I get support on both sides. And it's a long motion, so I've been working on this. So the motion for the Hampton Beach Village District to support the Hampton Beach Area Commission's recommendation to the Board of Selectmen that they accept the responsibility of the sidewalks on the west side of Ocean Boulevard only when DOT secures federal and state funding and completes Ocean Boulevard reconstruction project. Note, there is no money to be matched by the town. I'm just going to go off a little. No money for the town to secure funds. This is the state and federal government paying for Ocean Boulevard, not the town paying for Ocean Boulevard. And so that's my motion. So I would like to, if we can get a second on that and vote on that, I really think it's important.
I have questions, though.
Yeah.
There'll be no money from the town put into this. It will be all federal and state funding, you said.
To build and
to build it. Okay. All of the reparations that will be town?
The reparations for
when the sidewalks have a big dig in it, or they have a...
The town to maintain the sidewalks. That's the state does not maintain sidewalks. So
okay.
Right now, any sidewalk that you go down, and we all walk the beach, we see the holes and everything else, and
yeah.
There's a lot of property owners that have gone and redone the front of their buildings.
Mm-hmm.
Technically, they're not supposed to do that.
Oh.
But a lot of those people had holes and divots and flooding issues with the sidewalks. So that's why it needs to be done.
Okay, so do we have a guarantee with this motion that the town will indeed be accepted? Are we doing this?
No,
to
we're
see if
we're
they
asking
will?
The town. We're asking for support from the town to accept this.
Okay. Okay.
Right, so it's just us going to them, telling them that we feel it's necessary.
Hmm.
And
okay.
Mm-hmm. Any other questions?
Well, I wonder if
anybody in the audience want to talk.
Chuck, you mentioned at the beginning of this discussion, you said the state wants to do this. So you're saying the state has finally turned around a little bit and be receptive to having this done?
The state has been wanting to do it for a long time.
But the issue with the sidewalks has always been...
The issue with the sidewalks is the state does not maintain sidewalks anywhere in the state of New Hampshire.
So they would rebuild Ocean Boulevard. They would put in and install sidewalks, all ADA compliant,
right.
And so on. Once the project is done, then the town is going to take over the responsibility of maintaining the sidewalks.
That's the wording.
Good.
Question. This is not a new issue. This came up a few years ago.
Well, that's it, but now it seems that they...
Wait, so it's coming up again. That's all right. It's coming up again. Wasn't there a warrant article with the town of Hampton a couple of years ago asking the people of Hampton if... about this particular issue? I don't remember. I remember there was conversation about it. I don't remember if there was a warrant article.
I don't remember.
I believe it was halted.
But there was no warrant article.
There was no warrant article because everyone was...
I'm just wondering. Because, of course, there's no tax impact to do the project. But after it's done, okay, so the town maintains it. The one thing that I would wonder about is that the town, I hope... doesn't ask the property owners to
Right now, the property owners now are paying tax to be on Ocean Boulevard.
I'm hoping they don't ask the property owners to remove the snow that gets piled up in front of their properties because I don't know where I'd put it. I honestly don't. That would be a problem for me, but I don't know. They don't do it now. Nobody does it, so I don't know if they'd ask in the future. I'm just putting it out there as a comment.
Do you think when the town is going to be required to maintain it, they are including snow removal with that maintenance, or is this
probably?
Because like Stephen said, there's nobody here to shovel those sidewalks.
Well, there's no place to put the snow. That's the other thing. I don't know where.
Well, if it didn't pile it.
Well, right now, Dred clears the sidewalks on the other side.
Well, the boardwalk. I understand that, but my question is, snow removal, is it going to be required, and who's going to be responsible for it?
The town would have to maintain the sidewalks, so whatever it takes to maintain the sidewalks. The advantage to the town is the betterment of the beach. The betterment of the beach gives better properties, gives better tax revenue.
I recognize that, and I understand, and I agree. I was just wondering, for how many hundreds of years now, nobody's ever shoveled, unless you have a business that happens to be open year-round on that side of the street.
I think you made a good point about, too, the idea that the maintenance, nobody really has a clear-cut definition of what that means. Perhaps in the definition should be maintain, repair, snow removal would be a nice touch in the...
And it would be nice to have clear sidewalks.
No, but I mean, in this particular motion, I think might be a good idea to have that.
You want to add to this?
I think we should.
Well, first of all, I want to say I would love to see those sidewalks down the beach. I think the problem with the town, the Board of Selectmen, is that they're just not, they want to actually get more information. Like the state come in and saying, you either do this now or it's not going to go into the 10-year plan. That's not enough for the town. They want to sit down with the rep, with Dred, with DOT.
And I think we can do that. I mean,
and
that's not the
major issue. They want to know what is actually going to happen.
Well, I've been in those meetings. And so it's not like we haven't had these meetings. I've been in those meetings, I want to say 6-7 years ago I was in that meeting.
Like
no one wants to work together. We need to work together.
Well, it's a different board now.
It is a different board, and I think we're... Well, we can move forward with the board.
I think that, you know, if we get 150 feet of snow like we did 2 winters ago, I mean, DPW, they had to spend like almost $330,000 to hire someone to come in, remove all that. So, I mean, that's you know, a lot of money. Hopefully, you know, if every winter was like this, we'd, you know, all set, you know, no big deal. But, you know, that's what, you know, sitting down with Chris or whoever and just like getting everyone together, I really think that's best way.
Well, then I think the selectmen have to move forward to do that.
Bob? I think the issue before too. Oh, sorry, Bob. The issue before this was you kept saying that it's come up before.
Right.
The issue always was the selectmen did not want to maintain the sidewalks. That's why it kept coming up.
Right, but now, if this was a few years ago. Like now, we have Chris. We have it's different people.
That's good.
So I think if we all like get together, you know, HBAC here. Board, or even some of us from the board to begin with, you know, something, and actually sat down and figured out, okay, you know, talk to the people from the state, you know, what's going to happen.
It's a good idea.
What do we need from us? What do we need from you? Because it should be two ways.
First of all, let me just say, if we had 300 feet of snow, never before have I ever seen the town and the beach and the state work together so well, so fast, to clear that snow out of here. I think that Hampton, a lot of us, the Beach Commission, have been building a new rapport with the state. The state, when we talk to DOT and Dred, we've come a long way, and I think it's important to continue to work together. I was out walking this morning in anticipation of this meeting, and I started down on the South Beach. You know, we all think about the center is where the Rexall store is, but I sat on the South Beach, and you walk up by all those cottages, and you see the road, And you have the roads nice, and then it goes, and you see various layers of roads that's deteriorated, and then we're looking at sand. And I'm talking both sides, not just the west side. The east side of the South Ocean Boulevard, you know, really, really would look much better if we figure put in sidewalks on both sides. This is the gateway of Hampton Beach. Now, we can talk about what the town did years ago, and $12 million, and all that infrastructure, which really kickstarted all this. But I got to tell you, that included sidewalks. All of Ashworth Avenue has sidewalks, and the town did it. Now we're talking about the state giving us minimum of $6 million. $6 million. That is a lot of money, which will change the whole gateway, the whole beach. There's so many things, you know, new, wider sidewalks on one side. There are so many things in this picture that I think we really have to consider. And then when you look at what it's going to do for our assessments and the new building and how what it's going to do for all of us, I don't care if you say it costs us $200,000 or $300,000, we're going to get it back in appreciated values in the town's tax base. This, to me, is a no-brainer. Really, who's going to give you $6 million and say afterwards you guys get to shovel? I'll shovel mine. I will. I'll come shovel yours. I, you know, this is a big deal.
I'm going to hold you to that. Everybody heard that.
I was talking to her.
Oh.
No, I really think this is a big deal for Hampton. And for us to turn down $6 million because we think that the state is tucking it to us. I'm sorry, we're going to hear that a week and a half from now. Hampton, you know, the state makes so much money on us, and they don't give anything back. I don't agree with that. We have beautiful roads that bring people to Hampton. We have the state of New Hampshire that spends money on tourists and tourism.
Amen.
To bring people here. The state does a lot for us. I just wrote a check to Internal Revenue, and it went to Washington. I don't think I'm getting anything back. That's not the way it works. This is a way for us to develop the beach, and to vote otherwise, I think, is a mistake. Thank you.
Yes. Just putting aside, you know, the business community here at the beach, but think of it townwide. As a property owner, aren't you responsible for the sidewalk in front of your property?
I don't know if there is a law in this town.
An ordinance or anything. I'm not sure.
I don't know. In Boston, perhaps.
Yeah.
Right now, the town has a small little plow that does the sidewalks in town.
Well, that's it. They do the sidewalks in town.
Right.
You know? So I don't think we're talking about a massive amount of money to maintain or to plow the sidewalks at the beach. They already have the equipment. They do it at the town. How do you exempt the beach from that same service if it's being done in town? And again, I think that, you know, I've heard of the property owner is responsible for the sidewalk in front of his building.
That's an old.
I didn't know that certain towns have that as a.
Some towns do. I don't know if they have it here or not.
Chuck, I have a question.
Yeah.
Are you talking about both sides of the street sidewalks or just the west side?
I think they're doing everything.
Are you talking as far as the town?
Oh, no, just the west side.
The west side.
So the town side.
The east side anyway.
We're talking about redoing Ocean Boulevard.
Right.
So it's a hole you're going down.
Well, he was asking if they have to maintain the east side of the street. No, it's only the west side.
I mean, there would still be an east sidewalk, you know, along
Red,
where the water is.
Red has bent over backwards to work with us down here. They're going to continue to snowplow, you know, the east side. Well, I call it the pretty side. All right, it's the ocean side. That's
right.
The views. But you know, it's the easy way to shovel because that's the sunny side. Nobody walks down the west side of Ocean Boulevard.
They can't. They can't, Bob. It's such a mess.
You're in the shadow. Even now, you're in the shadow. People walk down the pretty side because it's all flat. There's no slippery. You're not looking about checking for cars. You're not going up and down first. They're gonna snowplow that for us all the way to Boar's Head. That's where the people are walking.
Well, that's what I was asking because they bought a special bobcat with a special snowblower attachment to the front of it, and they from Haverhill all the way up, they just run that machine up there, and it's great, and they just dump the snow onto the sand and it just melts. So that was just a little question I had. I wondered if
so, and also we're very fortunate. Senator Stiles is head of the
DOT.
She's head of DOT.
Well, the DOT in In the Senate.
In the Senate.
She's in charge of transportation.
And so this stuff's going to move forward because Senator Stiles is there. She's done so much for us in Hampton. The Seacoast, she's done so much for us. So I really feel this is the time that we need to make this happen before that money is gone. Because if we miss this, it could be 20 years. And those sidewalks are horrible now. They're only going to get worse. Yeah. And we all know. Every single person here walks down that boulevard. We all know what it's like. So I think we need, I think we should support this motion to the selectmen. And I think we should sit down and write them a letter as well.
Okay.
All right?
I did this 6 years ago. It's going to cost about $350,000 a year for the town to do this. You're talking overtime. They don't have the manpower. You're talking about buying new machinery. They refuse because of the cost. I've been down this road, and I'm just saying it won't be easy. Not only that, you're putting the burden on Hampton for that west side. Someone falls, slips, town of Hampton.
Is it not the town of Hampton now, though?
No.
The municipalities don't have a big liability.
No. For stuff like that. I'm giving you what I went through six years ago.
I think that, we're looking backwards instead of forwards. We need to look forward. And we need, I think that, and I don't agree with those figures. No. I just don't agree with them. I don't think it will cost that much. Maybe 1 year, if we have a year like last year, maybe we'll have a tough year. But most years, we don't get that kind of.
I wasn't looking at the year that it was calculated, but that was the issues that were brought up to me at that time. And
even
that's
so,
why they wanted DOT to take care of the whole thing. And maybe if we get a good start, then we can work.
And I think if you have well-made sidewalks, you're not going to have issues of
it should be go at least 10 years, 10 to 12 years.
When is this meeting going to be, Chuck?
Not next Monday, the Monday after.
23rd.
23rd is?
It'll
yeah. Yeah. And if anybody in town, anybody wants to go, I think, huh? Excuse me?
Do you want attendance from us to support it?
I don't know if that's going to be a public hearing, so I don't. Do you know if it's a public hearing or if it's just a...
No, you can always speak in the beginning. You can
always comment.
Yeah.
You know, if you wrote a letter to the Board of Selectmen, mm-hmm. you know, with your thoughts, you might have a chance to lay things out, because if there's a lot of people, they may have to limit you to a minute or two or three. So I would put some comments to paper and send them in to the town manager, and they'll pass them on.
And have them put it on record, whatever letter you sent.
I would have a couple of comments. The state has just spent millions of dollars to redo the seawall at North Beach. On the other side of that street, it's all Hampton property that's being protected by that seawall. Further, if 12 years ago, the state had come to Hampton and said, we'll do all your streets down at the beach. We'll do the shorelines and we'll put in sidewalks as long as you plow them. That was an offer. I don't think we would have refused. And as far as $300,000, there are thousands private contractors who would do that for an infinitely small piece of that $300,000. Mm-hmm. If it costs $300,000 to plow 3 miles of sidewalk, how do we do what we did for $300,000 when we had the worst snow in the history of the town?
We
moved it up. We had a...
Yeah.
Yeah. We moved all this... Yeah. But look what we did for the same amount of money. We moved all the snow from the beach down to the state park. And you're saying it will cost $300,000 to plow a sidewalk? I don't think so.
For the course of a year, I'm talking about the...
Maybe we could be the... Yeah.
Yeah.
Equipment.
Well, I would say then you should get some bids from private contractors.
I'm going to buy a machine.
Yeah.
My $300,000.
I hope it's a no-bid contract.
Okay. All right, so the motion's on the table. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor? Thank you. All right. So tonight I said Glenn was going to be here, and I just have a rundown of some of the things going on. Maureen already mentioned the Grand March. The following weekend's Memorial Day weekend, we have Saturday the Eastern Sound Band. Sunday we'll have the auditions in the afternoon for the
29th, 1 to 4.
Sunday night the Continentals and fireworks. Monday from 1 to 4 we have Andy Mowatts and the Steely Jam or something like that. Not quite sure what that is. Glenn always surprises us with some of these things.
Is that so? Monday night, the fireworks involved in any of that?
Sunday night.
Sunday.
After the Continentals.
I know that the man who's doing the 1 to 4 DJ said to me, "I'm going on." He announced at Millie's that he was opening the opening act for the Continentals. It's probably. I knew he would enjoy that.
No, he's
still glad.
He's after the Continentals the next day. He's on Monday.
Well, who's on Sunday night?
Sunday night is the Continentals.
That's what he said. I'm the opening act on Sunday afternoon.
He's playing Monday.
Who?
I don't know, whoever you're telling.
No. Sunday. So Sunday 1 to 4, May 29th.
So somebody, oh, I see what you're saying. So
you are incorrect. Sunday 1 to 4.
Sunday. Well, I have what he just sent me. I don't know.
Well,
so.
That's no, it says May special, 29.
It says special event on the website.
Yeah.
The 29th.
Right. Does it say 1 to 4 p.m.?
Yes.
That's us. That's the audition. That's Sunday.
The audition.
He's the opening act for the Continentals.
Okay.
Well, I'm sure he's good, whoever he is.
Yeah.
He's very good. Chris Michaels.
We'll see. I think it's Monday, but we'll disagree right now, and we'll see.
No. Don't. Go both days. It's not Monday.
I'm just telling you what he sent me.
I don't care what, it's Sunday afternoon.
Sunday afternoon, you're doing your tryouts.
Right.
Be nice now.
And what are you talking about?
I'm talking about Monday. Some other band is playing Monday. All right. All right, so you're talking about someone that's auditioning.
Yeah.
All right, so that's a different story.
Sunday.
So Monday we have some jamming Steely Band.
And we don't know there because he can't even read it.
1 to 4.
I move to have this tape edited.
Bleeped.
All right. All right, moving along.
Yes.
Approval of minutes from April 13th.
Oh, I don't have
to. You always have. Joan always has.
Please
pardon
me.
Oh, God. Page 1. Page 2. Page 3. Page 4. Do I have a motion to approve the minutes from April 13th, 2016?
I move to approve the minutes of April 13th as written.
Is there a second?
I will second.
All in favor? Done. Okay, here's the fun part. Public comment.
Can I just say to our secretary, this must have taken you a long time, and we appreciate it.
On that
quite
one.
A bit of rhetoric going on. But that was delightful of you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay, public comment. Anybody from the public want to speak that hasn't?
Seeing none. Oops.
Oh. Hi, I'm Kathy Silver, director of the Blue Ocean Discovery Center. And we have a very big day coming up on June 4th. This is World Oceans Day. Actually, it's like the next Tuesday, but we figured we'd celebrate on Saturday the 4th. And the day starts off at 9 o'clock with a run for the ocean. And this is a 5K, and it starts right on the boardwalk, right by the Discovery Center, goes north on the boardwalk, then onto the beach, and goes south all the way down to the state park area, then winds through the island portion of the beach, back onto the boardwalk, and then finishes up right at the Discovery Center area again. So this is a run/walk. If you'd like to participate in this, you can just go to our website, blueoceansociety.org. We had a meeting last night, and I didn't realize that runners and walkers, their times are computerized. So.
Whoops. Somebody's running.
Hey. So with your enrollment, you get a special bib that has a computer chip in it. And it's all synced to the computers. And I I know they do this with the Boston Marathon, but I never thought something this small, but I was mistaken. So, you can find out how fast or slowly you run or walk this race, because, like, we're deciding how many bibs to buy. And so that, I thought that was pretty interesting. I mean, this is high tech.
You can't pull Rosie Louise then, huh?
Jump
on the subway?
Right. Yeah, this is high tech. And the first 150 registrants get a free T-shirt. And, of course, everybody gets the bib, which I guess is a big deal. Seems so to me. So, anyway, then at 10:30, we have a beach cleanup, which will happen right on the main beach. And then at 12 o'clock, a concert on the stage. Now, if running or walking is not your thing, we desperately need volunteers. We need at least 50 people to line the route of the race to make sure that our runners and walkers go the right way. Also, this has all been carefully measured by Millennium Running. Millennium Running is organizing the whole thing. So this is a regular 5K race. So if this is something you'd like to do, 8 o'clock that morning, we'd like to have you come to the stage Discovery Center area, and we'll have you stand out along the route. And basically, it sounds to me like a pretty fun job. You just applaud the people, you know, good job kind of thing, and make sure they follow the right place. And it'll all be marked out, but the last thing we want is some person who's now worried about their computer time going the wrong way. So we don't want that to happen. So, I have a lot of kids from Winnicunnet who are going to help, and I might say Anthony Rage is one of them. Okay. And
Boston.
Yes. So this, I think, will be a very, very fun day. And if anybody out there has a pop-up tent, you know the type I mean, we are in need of borrowing your tent for the day. We have several sponsors who are coming, and we'll be underneath their tents giving away things. And it's similar to like at the Sandcastle event. You know, we've got a lot of people out there in that area between the parks and Discovery Center and the beach. So it'll be a fun thing to attend.
Don't we have a pop-up tent?
I think Glenn has a...
Okay.
Yeah, I was,
thank you.
Yeah, we have them.
All right. So, okay, we'll talk. Because we need tents.
Yeah.
Okay, so that was my big message of the night, was we need tents and we need volunteers for that day. Second, the Blue Ocean's mission, so to speak, is research. We do lots and lots of work with researching all the whales in the Gulf of Maine here. And we do the beach cleanup data. And then our next part is to educate, so that's teaching people about all these things. And finally, to inspire action and to try to convince people to maybe act a little more pro-environmentally for the environment. So with that in mind, I'm going to try to bring a message each month. And this month, we'd like to have anybody who does business at the beach or is at the beach to please discourage balloon releases. I met a family the other day, and they had 20 blue helium balloons. And it was a very windy day, and they were all ready to let them go. And I talked with them, I understood their reasoning, but these balloons are very, very bad for marine life. The animals ingest the balloons, and then they can't digest anything else, and so they starve to death. And then the strings that are on the balloons, the ribbons, entangle a lot of animals. So if we could maybe kind of band together. I know we... Aren't the lanterns now illegal?
I was just going to ask you, those things they light up and they burn, are they gone?
Well, I know that in the summer on the signs that say use the crosswalks and et cetera, it says no lanterns allowed.
They're so illegal.
They are. Well,
left. He wasn't there last summer.
Who's that?
The gentleman that solar is gone. So I think they are.
Okay.
I believe they stopped them.
Yeah.
I thought they did too.
Well, as well, they should have, but we would truly like everybody to, not encourage balloons being released. Okay, it's just not right for the environment at all.
I just sell water balloons.
Water balloons are fine.
As long as they don't throw them in the ocean.
As long as I don't throw them in the ocean.
Can you get the state involved in that?
I would love to. It's very, very difficult. We have many little irons in the fire, so to speak. We're trying to get plastic bags, smoking, cigarettes. I mean, all of these are big issues, which brings me to my next one. The Ocean Conservancy, which is like a huge, we're kind of like, we do the beach cleanup as part of them. Their big push this year is going to be to have restaurants ask people if they really need a straw. Because one of the most numerous items that we pick up on the beach are plastic straws. And many people, if you say to them, do you want a straw? We're hoping that they would say no. Because these...
What about paper straws?
That's fine. Okay, paper straws would be fine. If the restaurants would change to paper straws, that would be very, very good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but these plastic straws are tough. Okay, I know personally, I pick up lots and lots of straws, and then the ones that come on the little juice boxes, and then the plastic that goes around the straw on the little juice box. Okay, people just throw those things like crazy. So, and then the other thing is next Tuesday, the Science Club from Winneconnet is coming to clean the beach along with the Interact Clubs from Winneconnet and from Seabrook Elementary. And I promise you that we will clean the playground.
Great.
Okay, I know that's always a big one. So that is right on the list. Okay, I'll get the Winneconnet kids to do the playground. Okay.
Okay. Before you leave, because I'm sure you might know a little more than I do on this one. It's Kites for Cancer this weekend, isn't it? Do you know anything about that?
I don't know about
it's
that.
Sunday. Yes, it's
Sunday.
Sunday.
Yeah.
It says Sunday.
Yeah. So from 11 to 3 at the Pavilion. Is that right?
Right. That's correct.
Okay. So that's... And then there's a rain date for May 22nd. I just want everybody to know about that. It's a great cause.
We're hoping it doesn't rain.
We always hope it doesn't rain.
Opening this week.
Okay. Chamber's opening.
Okay.
That's big news.
Will we have lottery this weekend?
Yes, you will.
All right, we'll set them down.
The lottery's been set up for 2 weeks.
All right, excellent. Good.
All we need is a weather, right, Jules?
Yes, you're correct.
Any other public comment? Yes, Mr. Grady.
Greg Grady, I'm the local sculptor organizer for the sand event. Just to update you a little bit, let you know, the sand will be coming in less than a month from today, June 10th. The competition is the 16th through the 18th. And we're removing it right after the tween event on July 7th this year. We're looking for volunteers also. It's a good way to get out there and get involved and meet some new people. You can sign up online, would be the easiest thing. Go to hamptonbeach.org, go to the event, sand sculpture event, and there's a link right there that'll walk you right through signing up. Or you can call Jim Melissus. His number is 603-327-7154. It'd be easier if you could sign up online so we could organize the whole thing. We're going to try to keep it low-key and let the sculptures take care of themselves this year. We just want somebody down there to keep anybody from getting hurt and getting into the actual sand pit. We have a really good lineup this year. We have a new sculptor coming in, Melanage Beauregard from Montreal. She's just coming off of a win out of Fulong, Taiwan. 18 world-class international sculptors. She took first place there. also returning will be Abe Waterman. He just came out of Port Aransas, Texas, where he took first place. Karen Freilich was in Taiwan with them. She took first place here last year. So we have a really, really good crew coming in. It should be a fantastic event. I can't wait to see what
this is. How many sculptors?
10 total. And we have one as an alternate, Morgan Rudloff out of Santa Cruz. She will be given lessons and things like that down there. So I'm really looking forward to it. Looks like a great year. Anybody have any questions? Great. Thank you.
Thanks, Greg.
This is me.
This is not doing it till the 8th of June.
What's this mean?
I don't know. All right. So, and any other public comment? Mr. Preston.
Yeah, thanks, Jeff. Just one more. Speaking for the board of directors for the Hampton Mountain Patrol at Ocean Gaming this week, starting tonight for the next four nights. Those are our nights. So whatever, if we choose to go down and support the horses, we're going to use that money to build up our kitty in case the town decides that we need another horse.
So how many days?
It's these four nights. We have three more in August and three more in the fall. But I think the Hampton Mountain Patrol is an important thing for Hampton Beach. Mm-hmm. Anytime we can have horses out there and kids going up and approaching our policemen, I think that's a wonderful thing. So if you're inclined to support the Mountain Patrol, stop into Ocean Gaming this week and say hello.
Also, their crowd control, when it's needed, is amazing. Yeah. People move when they have a 2,000-pound horse coming at you. All right. So on that, closing comments? Any closing comments?
Oh, I don't have anything.
Bob?
The season's here, and you should all thank each other. What the precinct does is pay so much forward to so many people in so many ways in terms of their summer vacations. All recent studies have shown that an experience, if you're spending money on an experience, i.e. a vacation, a show, a trip, it's far more rewarding than buying a thing. And what this is all about is experience. So it's really a wonderful thing. Keep supporting it.
One other thing is Maureen is not going to be able to make next month's meeting, so I'd like to change next month's meeting to the 15th of June.
Good, because I wasn't going to be able to.
Nice, and I will have everybody that's important here then. All right, so June 15th, same time, same place.
Thank you.
Okay. I also, I'm not going to talk about it. I'm just going to mention it. The Village District got together with Professor John Tomasi, who's also a Hampton cop. And we had this student of his, Lin Zhang, is that how you say
it? Zhang, I think so.
Do a economic analysis on the Hampton Beach Village District. I just received it, so I don't really know anything about it yet. So I'm going to give one to each of the commissioners. We'll look it over, and then we'll discuss it next month. So we'll talk about some. It looks really interesting, and it's kind of exciting. And I might have to get someone to explain a little bit of it to us, too. So.
You might invite the young lady. It's never been done.
And this young lady used this analysis at her last at her job interview, and she got this huge high paying job because of this analysis in Boston. So they were very, very impressed with it. So hopefully we'll be as impressed. So.
We're always paying it forward.
That's right. So when she really makes it big, we'll have to have her all right, so we'll talk about this next month. All right. On that note, we're going to adjourn the meeting. This is a quick meeting, 6:21. Thank you very much.